The AI website and app Ideogram added something new, and it's called tiles. And what it is, it's for patterns. So you can tile your patterns. There's different things that you can do. And patterns are used for a lot of different things on print on demands, like phone cases and tote bags and duvet covers and shower curtains and just so many things on Redbubble. So what I'm gonna do in this video, I'm gonna show you how the patterns work in Ideogram. We're gonna do some different things on there. I'll show you some best tips and tricks, and then I'm gonna show you how you can export it or download it and then import it or upload it to Redbubble and put it on different products. So let's go to Ideogram right now and I'll show you this new thing with tiles. Okay, so here we are on Ideogram or Ideogram. I like to call it Ideogram. .ai right here, and you can see this is the explore page, and if we scroll down we won't see very many patterns, and that's because not a lot of people know about it. Well, maybe not a lot of people want to use it, I don't know, but you can see not a lot of patterns here, right? And that's because if you come in here and go to generate, you won't see it right here. You have to actually click this filters bar or box icon, and then you'll see right here tile on or off. We're gonna turn it on and we're gonna see the different types of grid. So you may not know this if you haven't used this before, but you can do off, you can do grid, which does like a 9 grid. You can do a vertical brick, whoops, vertical brick. You can see the difference. It tiles this way, but not exactly this way. So kind of a mix match. And then horizontal brick kind of does the same way, but kind of offset a little bit. And column, which is just one thing, one at a time. And then row, which is just one at a time that way. So let me just go through here. I was clicking on it, but here, row, column, horizontal brick, vertical brick, grid, and off. And so I'll try and do a few of each one so you can see the difference. So first one I'm gonna do is a flower pattern. This works great. This is one of the very basic ones, but it does really good. So I'm gonna do a colorful flower pattern using different flowers, but I want it to be like a vector illustration, so we can also still use these things right here. So illustration, is there vector? No, but I think illustration will be good. We'll see what that comes out to. So let's hit generate. It's going to do 4 again. Remember, oh, let's do the first one. Let's just do grid. So it's going to do that 9 grid. It's not going to be offset or anything. And then, yeah, let's do this. Boom. Okay, so it's going to take a little while. I'll come back and I'll show you what the results are. Okay, so here are the results. Pretty cool results, right? Like if you click on here, you'll notice it plays and you can make it bigger or smaller. Look at this, just to show you how good the tiling is. And you can see it repeats. There's that sunflower. So it's kind of a grid there. Really cool, right? Here's the second one. This one kind of has the column idea because it has that white space. Not as cool as the other one, but it's still nice. This is really cool here. You can use that as a pattern. And imagine these on duvet covers or shower curtains or phone cases, right? Really cool idea. So what you do now is when you export it, it doesn't export the whole thing. It can export in tiles. So let me show you. I'll pause this here. And let's say I want this one. I'm going to download here. So we hit this meatball, the 3 dots, click on it on with the one that you want. You can come down here and you can download it 1x1 tile, 2x2 tile, 4x4 tile, 8x8 tile, doesn't really matter, but we'll do 1x1 tile so you can see the difference. And then we'll do a 4x4 tile so you can see the difference. And I'm gonna bring these up so you can see what it would look like. So here's the difference. Here's the 1x1 tile. You can see a little bigger. If we made it smaller, you would notice that it would fit like right here. But this is a 4x4, so you can see one, you can count these, right? There's only one of these in there. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4. So it kind of 4 of these by 4 of these, and this kind of shows you, but they're still repeating tiles. So if you took one of these tiles and you put it into Redbubble, which we're gonna do later, they'll just repeat and you can make a bigger one. So I would just do the 1x1. I think that's fine. You don't have to do this unless you don't want it to repeat. So if you wanted to use this 4x4, let me see how big the 4x4 is. So the 4x4 is 4,000 by 4,000. So it would fit on a phone case without having you repeat it, or it would fit on some other products without you repeating it. My guess is the 8x8 would be 8,000 by 8,000 or so. And so you could put that on bigger things too. So whether or not your print on demand site can repeat and tile stuff, which Redbubble can, maybe the print on demand site that you use doesn't do that, so you might want to do this. So they're just giving you options on which way to do it. Of course, this is a bigger file. This is 6 megabytes. Let's see, the one by one. The 1x1 is 1024 by 1024, which makes sense, and it's only 1.6 megabytes, so it saves you a lot of space. All right, so I wanted to test it out again, and let's do some geometric patterns, but then do the offset patterns that they have. So let's do this. So I just did a real simple prompt, geometric pattern, whoops, I forgot the N, with different shapes and colors. And let's do this one. We're gonna try out some of these things here too. Let's do conceptual art. I think that's really cool. And let's do that. Let's make sure that we have, let's click on here. See, by default, the grid turns off. So we're gonna come in here. We'll do the vertical brick this time so you can see the difference, and we'll hit generate. Now here's the result of those. Let's look at these. So you can see now it's not just repeating right across. You can see this is here and it kind of goes at an angle like we saw. Same thing with this one, right? Kind of coming in an angle instead of straight across. This one too, you can't really tell because it's all together, but it's, you know, it's a pattern, same. And this one, so my favorite is really this one. This would be a cool pattern. And then let's pause it and we can, same thing, come in here and download it right there. And you can do 4x4, 8x8, 1x1, and so on. So that's really cool. And then you can change the color. So if you wanna remix this, hit remix and then try different colors. Let's see this. Pastel colors, let's try that. And hit generate and let's see what happens. So it's gonna take the same thing that we just did, use that as a base, and then create something else that's similar. And here we go, this is the result really quickly. This one kind of has a 3D look, but it has almost the same kind of look that we had before. Here's the parent, here's this one, right? And this one, and this one, really cool. All right, so you notice down here it said describe. So the next thing we're gonna do is go look for a pattern online and then use that, bring it into Ideogram, and then have it describe it and then produce something. I'll show you what I mean. All right, so I came here, Google, I did 70s retro pattern, and let's just do this one. I like this one right here, kind of nice wavy lines. I'm just gonna grab it and drag it to my desktop, just like that. I'm gonna go back to Ideogram, click here. So next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on here, right here, image upload. I'm gonna get the image that I just did, that I put on there, and we can hit describe. And this is what it describes it at, so we don't have to write the prompt. And if we wanna change the colors, maybe we don't want blue or orange or whatever, we can do that. But let's see what it comes up with, and let's make sure that we have our grid on again, so it turns off by default. And I kinda liked the row, because it looks like rows across. So I'm gonna do row and generate. Wow, so these are some really cool patterns. Not exactly like the one that we saw, but it's also a really cool pattern. So check this out. This is the row of patterns. Here's another one where it's just one row. So you can see it's not the whole thing, but this would repeat back and forth. So we're gonna try this repeating as well. Here's another one. You can see it kind of connects that way. And this one, kind of cool, right? So I'm gonna download this one as well, just so we can see that it works. And I'm gonna do the 1x1 tile, and we're gonna have that. So we have that 1x1 tile and the one that we did before. I didn't do the geometric one, but I still have it. So if you wanna go back to Ideogram, you would go back to your stuff, so my profile. And these are all the ones that we did today. And if I went to the geometric one, this one right here, if I like this one, I can save this too. So I'm gonna save this one, download, let's do 1x1 again. Okay, so now that we've made our patterns, we can go online, we can get pattern ideas from others, have Ideogram describe it, come up with other things, And so we can make a ton of patterns really quick, really fast, and these are all able to tile. So let's go into Redbubble right now, and I'll show you how to use the tile feature on Redbubble to put it on things like duvet covers, phone cases, and so on. All right, so here we are on Redbubble. Yours may look different because this is my recently viewed and so on, but we're on Redbubble. You just gotta click on your account here and go to add new work. So I'm gonna do that. So we'll do the first flower pattern that we did, and I'll just drag it into here. Remember, it's that 1x1, which is 1024 by 1024, which is small, but that's okay because we're gonna repeat it. And we can say flower pattern up here, and we can give us some tags. I'm just gonna show you how to upload it though. So it's already uploaded. We don't need a background. And look at this. So you can see it doesn't fit the phone case because it's only 1024 by 1024. But if we click on it and we edit it and we use this thing right here where it says choose pattern, we can do a regular grid. And look at that. It fills the whole thing. Really cool, right? And you can size it down too. So if you want the flower smaller, check it out right there. Or if you want it bigger, it goes to that big, right? As small as that or big like that. Let's try something else. This works on so many things. I'm gonna just do a few. So pillows is another one. Now this doesn't work on Merch by Amazon. So Merch by Amazon doesn't have this feature with choose pattern, but that's when you would download the 8x8 or the 4x4 and then use it. But let's do this here, regular grid. Look at that. Fills the whole thing. I'm gonna have to enable it. Really cool, right? Now you could do the offset, but I think because this wasn't made as an offset, it wouldn't look good. Yeah, you can see the line here. So don't do offset, do regular grid and you'll be fine. Now for the big one, duvet covers and shower curtains, right? You can see how small it is, but again, doesn't matter because we can pick regular grid and there you go, boom. Now it can only get smaller, but it can get up to this big right here. Now, if you wanted that bigger, that 1024 by 1024 bigger, you may have to upscale it and make that 1024, that tile bigger if you want the pattern bigger on the duvet cover. But I think this pattern on the shower curtain and duvet cover is fine. Now you can do it with almost all of these have that feature on here. You can see the tote bag doesn't really fill the whole spot, but if we chose the pattern here, let's see. Oh yeah, it's only that rectangle, so it doesn't fill the whole spot on that case. I think the apron does fill the whole spot. Let's see, yep. And what's really cool are these bags down here, these duffel bags. So if I went here and edit it, regular grid, full bag. This one too is a great one to use it on. Like I said, there's almost every product on Redbubble can do that, can do the pattern. You can do it on leggings, on socks, and all these things. So try it out. Let me show you some of the other patterns, how they work. So we can replace this. If we click this, and instead of on my desktop, no, I went to my downloads. I picked that other one here. I think this is the geometric pattern, right? Oh no, the last one with the wavy lines. So same thing, we come in here. Even though this was the row, it still works, right? There you go, and you can size it down. Very cool, same thing here. Now if you replace the reason I didn't save it is because we replaced the picture, so we'd have to do this all over again if we replace the graphic, but it looks really cool. This one again, really quick. See how fast that is? Really cool. Okay, last one. Let's do that one right here. We're gonna replace image and we'll do this one. This is the geometric pattern. And let's do the pillow. I like the pillow. Boom, pretty cool, right? And it kind of has a line, does it? Let me zoom in here. Kind of does have a little bit of a line there, but that's okay. It repeats and it's okay. I think this is the one that we did the offset. So maybe don't do the offset ones for tiles. Let me see what happens if we do offset on offset. Oh, look at that. we offset the offset and it's kind of almost the same. So if you're gonna do these, my suggestion would be not to do the offset. So let's go back to Ideogram and I'll show you what I mean. So I wouldn't do this vertical brick or horizontal brick. I would just do the grid or the column or the row. I think those would work really well. But because these are kind of offset, they look good when it's done. But then if you're trying to do the tile version of that inside of Redbubble, I don't know if it works really well. You can try it out, but I think grid, column, and row probably be your best bet. So there you go, that's Ideogram and patterns on Ideograms. You can literally do hundreds and thousands of different ones. Try it out, try different ones, and if you're stuck, I would say go online and look for different patterns and then have Ideogram describe it and then come up with even more and kind of refine it. And it's just so fun to do. And it has tiles and you can use it for print on demand. Now, if you want to try another thing for patterns, if you love patterns, I have this video right here about Repper, which is really cool if you haven't tried it out, where you can use different things for patterns and mix all these geometric ones. It's really cool. You should check it out. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.